This weekend will be a bittersweet one for the world-famous Surf Ballroom in Clear Lake.
That's because it was 50 years ago on February 2nd that music legends Buddy Holly, Ritchie Valens, and J.P. Big Bopper Richardson died in that plane crash just after performing a concert at the Surf. Now the Surf is getting ready to greet thousands of music fans all converging on Clear Lake to commemorate the event. Angie Hunt joins us live via Newstar 8 Satellite with a story that's really just getting underway.
That's right, Kevin. This is actually going to be a week-long tribute to the men and their music. There are fans here in Clear Lake from all over the world to be here for this event, and it's really through their stories and their memories that you get a feel for what it was like to be here at the Surf on that final night in concert.
You can just close your eyes and you can just relive it.
It's been 50 years, but Karen Spratt can still remember that night. The music, the excitement of seeing Buddy Holly, Ritchie Valens, and the Big Bopper play at the Surf Ballroom.
You're 16, you're excited, you're hyper, your adrenaline's going, and you're just so thrilled to be here, and you can't believe you were here.
Like so many others, Spratt also remembers the next day, hearing the news of how all three died in a plane crash.
That was just a tragedy.
And there was a bulletin that a plane had gone down. I didn't put two and two together yet. I guess I was too sleepy. It didn't even dawn on me it could have been their airplane.
Bob Hale was a local DJ who had emceed the concert the night before and remembers how the weather started to change just after the show.
The wind was coming right across the highway, and I said to my wife, I hope these guys get off the ground before this came into town.
50 years later, the fans, family, and music legends are reliving those memories as the Surf Ballroom is inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. They're also honoring the men and their music and how it touched their lives.
And it was just the enthusiasm and the drive and the wonderful words in his music, simple but very much to the scene that we were when we were teenagers.
You can dance to it, you can laugh to it, and these were three geniuses who would have written music, produced music, would have been stars way into their 70s, I'm sure.
It's very comforting for me to see that after 50 years, they still enjoy just as well when they first listened to it.
And Buddy Holly's wife, Maria Elena, says that was very important to her husband. When he was composing music, he wanted to write music that people would like, would make them happy, and that they would remember. Now, there are concerts starting tonight that will go every night through Monday. A lot of big names that are going to be here at Clear Lake at the Surf Ballroom. They'll have the final tribute Monday night, and also a lot of fans, family members, other rock legends that are going to be here for this 50th anniversary tribute. Kevin and Stacey?
It'll be a great, great week. Thank you very much, Angie.